My name is Basti, and welcome to Basti Plays Minecraft. And today you're joining me from a place of hopes, dreams, and concrete pillars of doom. This is the city I'm working on. And this section is just a small, small part of it. This city is going to be massive. It's a huge project and it's going to take a lot of time. And so, as you do with any big project, you push it off until another day. Because I was walking around Basttown here, and I was thinking, well, it's gotten a bit neglected in these last episodes. And I would like to do some projects over here. And what better project to do than a project that I've been pushing off from episode 3. Yeah, I've had this thing in the works for a while now. And I thought today is the day we're gonna do it. Although we don't really need it anymore, but that's another point entirely. The thing is, since even before I built that cobblestone eyesore right there, I was thinking that it would be so cool to have a way to go from Basttown directly to the water with a little dock area for some boats. And right here is the perfect place for it. This place is almost ready built to be a staircase. And if you don't see what I mean, let me grab some dirt and I'll show you the vision. This is what I have in mind for the stairs. I seem to be running out of dirt for some reason. Can't imagine why. Well, anyways, this is the idea I have for the staircase. As you can see, it's just a plain old boring staircase for now. But once this is done, I think it will look beautiful. The reason I'm building it out like this is I want this here to come all the way down with stone and rock. And in between it, I want a layer of stupid water. I want a layer of like this kind of stuff, you know, like a dirt layer looking kind of grassy and beautiful. I'm thinking it would look something like this. You have the staircase going all the way up there. In between all of these stairs is a layer kind of like this with dirt. And you can imagine some grass growing on top of there and maybe some moss and azalea bushes and such. Giving it kind of like nature meets man kind of thing all the way up there. Don't question it. It will be beautiful. Don't worry. I got this. Let's get going with this. First step is to build the steps. Beautiful. And now with that part done, let me lay out some dirt tracks in between here. Like so. That looks good to me. Yeah, that'll be a fun shape to work with. Next, let's remove this dirt and start placing some stone. I am liking this. There's only one small problem though. Can you see it? Do you see it? I see it. Do you see it? Yeah. It doesn't really blend into the landscape very well. That's a slight issue. Slight issue. We could fix that. We could fix that. Like if we got that side, maybe, you know, a little bit more grass there and some like a hill up here, something. I don't know. Maybe something like this. Yeah, I think that's pretty decent, actually. Ignore the fact that it's nighttime right now. Okay. It took a little while. Took a little longer than it should have. but that's fine. You see, I think this project is a huge success. Now, let's actually take the stairs up to Basttown. Look at this now. I mean, it's a narrow staircase, but that is what I wanted it to be. I never wanted this to be a grand thing. I wanted it to be a small, intimate kind of affair. Like, it's supposed to feel dangerous. And, you know what? It really, really does. And it's pretty, pretty awesome, if you ask me. And that's probably the person you ask, right? Because, well, it really is only me here, actually. You know, this place is actually kind of empty.
Who are you, and what are you doing here?
I'm your brother. You invited me.
Oh yeah, he's my brother. I invited him. Do you wanna get a tour of the place?
Yeah, sure.
All right.
I'm quite poor right now. Do you have any rockets or anything?
Oh yeah, right. Sure. Rockets. There you go. I'm not used to having people over.
Company!
Company! Woo!
Wow, this is a beautiful house.
Thank you. This is my house. This is where I live. Don't mind the mess. I usually clean. Don't flip the trapdoors.
Which ones did you say I should flip?
No, none of them. Thank you.
Oh, I accidentally picked up a flower.
Oh, it's nighttime. Let's sleep. If we walk this way, good sir, this is my balcony. Yeah.
It's a very erect view. Very nice view. Good view.
Do you like the view to be erect?
No, it's a thing there. It's warm. I like warm.
There is a thing there. It is a bit of a cobblestone monstrosity. But I'm gonna move it. I'm gonna move it. Don't worry. Can back here, here, this is Basttown. Wait, where did you go?
Wait.
There you are.
In the bushes.
I was just assuming you went with me. This is Basttown.
Oh no. Never assume anything.
This is like my starter build. We can take things in chronological order as far as I can remember.
Great. That's great. I like that. And now we can see like also building skills evolving and stuff like that.
You actually can so much in this world. This is my...
This was the first one.
What? Nope. This one.
Oh, I thought you meant that one. Okay.
No, that's probably one of my best builds. What the heck?
I thought it was nice, so I don't know.
Yeah, so first I built this thing, and later on I came to this stuff. Oh. This is the starter base. The little wheat field around it.
Yeah.
Go inside. We can just walk around it. Inside is really boring. Cafe? Yeah, you can check it out.
Oh, but here I can see you like started experimenting with the theme. Like with the flowers and stuff. And,
let's say I did this when I built it, yeah. And not.
Oh, I think.
Not 14 episodes into the series.
I hadn't seen this before, so.
No, I realized that.
Yeah, I of course watch all of your videos. All of them. I've seen all.
being a good brother as you are, you watch all of the episodes.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Continue.
So this is episode one. Episode two, we, me and the audience, of course, they helped me with everything.
Of course.
We built this thing. Oh. I think, wait, was that episode two? Audience, help me, please. This was episode two, right? Wait. I should have put a sign somewhere. So this is my iron farm. It definitely works.
I can hear that it's an iron farm.
Yeah. I haven't... It was a bit of a hassle to, like, mob-proof all of this, but it does work really good. And nothing spawns outside where it should.
Could use some iron.
You grab iron.
I could use some.
yeah, for sure.
But I don't have a crafting table or anything or wood yet.
No, yeah. Oh, you have to push the buttons, yeah. I should do pressure plates, but, you know, I felt like buttons were more hidden and cool.
Yeah, but also buttons is decorations.
Yeah, basically. This was like my first experiment trying to make like a pretty farm.
I do really like the roads.
Are pretty sick, yeah. I'm gonna keep building this road like throughout the entire thing. I just haven't gotten around to it yet. This place has gotten a little bit neglected these past 10 episodes.
how many have you made?
11. 15.
Okay.
It's hard sometimes.
Oh, it's an honor to be in episode, what was it, 16?
16, yeah.
16, yes. I think that's the most honorable one.
Yeah, exactly. 16 is clearly the best episode to be in.
Yes, of course.
This, I think, also was episode 2. I did a lot in episode 2. I built an iron farm, and I brought villagers here and made a villager trading hall.
Oh, yeah, that's actually productive.
Yeah, the only slight little issue that I remembered in episode 2 was that I didn't really have emeralds to trade with them.
Oh, that's fun. Oh, here you have crafting table. I can make something out of this now.
Oh, yeah, you want some armor, maybe. Although I could give you some diamond stuff. I do have spare stuff.
This is cheap, at least.
That is very cheap.
I'm not that pretty. I'll remove my helm. My silver pants, it looks weird. Why are they so high?
I don't know, really.
Pants are so high.
Yeah, mine too.
I've never realized this before.
Yeah, look at mine as well. My shirt goes down to like my knees, but it's pretty it goes way above the navel.
Like it covers my suit buttons.
It does cover up your suit buttons.
That means it protects a lot.
It does protect a whole lot. Yeah, it does. So this is... Yeah, you see. Here, I put up a sign. Mm-hmm. This was episode 2. Look, I remembered. It says right here.
Ooh, made episode 2.
I try to put signs in some of these builds to remember which episodes they're from. So episode 3, I made this raid farm that you saw earlier. Yeah, we can fly to it. This is a kind of a cool design, actually. It saves the raid captain up here all the time, so you can just go kill him. Oh. We don't need to run this. There's a slight chance of dying, and I don't really want that right now.
It is also quite fun to run them, though. It is... See how they work.
Yeah, but I think one of us is definitely gonna die from that. So let's save the dying a little bit. Let's go back. We can go check out the armory.
Okay. This is like a recap episode. So for people who hasn't watched all of it, watch this one and like get a...
Glimpse back into time, yeah.
That means that people don't need to watch all of your videos.
That's a bad idea. Please watch all of the videos. So anyway, this here is the forge area, as you can see by the forge.
Yeah, it's cool. It's cool.
Yeah.
And I like this too.
In here, we have some armor stand magic and stuff. Oh yeah,
this is a very, very nice open fireplace.
Yeah, thank you. That. This is like a armory shop kind of thing.
Why can't I take it off? I'm trying to take off their things.
You have to have an empty hand.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, but this is all decoration. I have more stuff. This is staff only, so we're not allowed in here. But we can have a sneaky peek. There's
you can hire me. Hire me for a couple.
Oh,
of seconds.
Yeah, you're hired. Yeah, you work here now. Yeah, good. Now you can come in. So... This is the staff storage room where we store absolutely nothing so far.
Oh, I see.
At some point, I'm gonna spill over all the overflow of armor and stuff I have back in here. Just for more like fun storytelling storage. Ah, this is episode 4, apparently.
I see. So we're getting ahead.
No, I don't think so. I don't remember what I did episode 3. It's probably nothing important.
Now your audience is gonna be like,
how could you forget to build this thing?
You forget your first build.
It's my favorite build up here. We got like some more stuff. This is like some of the armor stand magic. But you see like the helmets and stuff lying around and sword and
stuff. Yeah, that is cool. It does a lot.
It does really improve a build. I need to use it more than I have. Yeah.
I've never really used it, and I don't even know how.
There's a book and it's a pain.
Oh.
If we go back here, there's not much really, but some log storage.
Yeah, I recognize this. I've seen this before.
Yeah.
Nice.
I think somewhere after building the armory, we did go, I went to the end and beat the Ender Dragon.
This is the monument
of me beating the Ender Dragon.
It is. This looks like a scary place.
Kind of, ish. I don't know. I wanted to make it look cool and Ender Dimension-y.
Dragon Head Tower, built in episode 5, when we defeated the Ender Dragon.
And got our wings. Story. Not the one you're wearing, but the ones I'm wearing. No, not the ones I'm wearing either. I lost those.
Easy. That happens. Way too easy.
Way too easy to lose everything. Don't look that way. We haven't gotten there yet.
Oh, I'm sorry.
There is lots of things here.
Yes, there is. This is a world.
This is a world. Oh, by the way, we should say... Oh, you got stuck. We should say hi to some of the animals. That is, if I'm not mistaken, Bacon.
Hello, Bacon.
And Ham is somewhere on this side of the cliff.
Did you place that flying block too? Or is it just a random flying block?
Don't notice that.
Oh, that's cool if it's natural.
No. Don't notice it. Back here we have Gribo. He's out here.
Where?
Here.
Oh, I hear him.
Yeah.
Hello, Gribo.
He's one of the many animals named by Christopher Yee.
Hello.
And after...
Can we go say hi? Will he fall down and die?
Probably don't mess up the animals, please.
Yeah, I'm not going to go too close. I'm just going to sit there and say hi.
I fell off.
There's also a horse down there. I don't think he has a name down there.
Yeah, there is a horse down here.
There's a lot of weird animals on the cliffside here for some reason.
Hello, horse. He's in the water, though.
He's been there for quite a while. This is the rocket shop. This is built episode 6 after we got wings and stuff, because, you know, rockets.
And there's like
a little
Team Rocket R there almost.
Yeah. Yeah, I thought it looked really cool. Inside of here, you can see my interior work suddenly make a bit of a leap from what you saw before.
I can already see with the gradients on the walls too. That also is definitely a step up. Oh, yeah, this is full of stuff.
This is a stair stolen directly from B-Dubs. I don't know if it's his design or anything, but I saw him do it in one of the Hermitcraft thingies. Yeah, you know, I'm right. Episode 6. It says right here.
Nice. Can we activate TNT when they're already small?
No. That's an armor stand holding a TNT block.
Okay.
So that's just like you holding a TNT block. You see here? This is a landing spot for Elytras.
Oh.
Yeah.
You have to be pro. I'm pro, so I'm going to show you how to do it.
Okay.
We're going to land there or we're going to fly in?
Land there. Nice.
What is this painting?
It's a painting. It's awesome. Have you not seen this before? I mean, the picture really tells the story, doesn't it?
It adds to the shop massively. Yeah. It's probably Bacon.
You know what? It might be Bacon. It could be Ham as well. One of the brothers, anyways. Yeah.
Bacon seems like an adventurous kind.
Yeah, that's why he's probably away from the other ones as well. He's adventured away a little bit more. Yeah. So this is the rocket shop.
Cool place. Good job.
I think after the rocket shop, I think I probably built this thing for Binky and Rincewind because, well, I think that's about when I went to the Deep Dark with Binky.
Yep, this is a nice table too.
Yeah, and there were like more lore stuff and epic moments and stuff. A lot of loud music and screamy voices. I think this is most of the stuff up here, actually. Except, do you want to see secret stuff?
Oh, is there secret stuff?
There's absolutely secret stuff.
Are you gonna show this in the video?
No.
Wow, that was literally the craziest thing on this server. Like, it's mad.
Yeah, I know. It was a bit of a grind, but you know.
I love it. It's beautiful.
It'll be finished someday, hopefully soonish. Over here is Ham.
Hello, Ham. Oh, he's really balancing.
Yeah, he's living a dangerous life.
Like, how did he even get there?
That is the mystery. I'm trying to solve it, but, you know, progress is tough.
these kind of things don't solve themselves, you know? You have to really keep at it.
It is slightly suspicious.
It is interesting, to say the least.
Yeah.
You know what? Let's go and have a look at some of the newer stuff on this world.
Yes!
And I think you'll really like this, actually. You know, let's take the road. I built the roads. So let's use them. This is going to be a city at some point. And this is as far as I've gotten. You can see the skyline.
Yeah, it looks really pretty.
And the thing is, it's going to cover basically all of the landmass there. Almost up until, like, you see the other side of the water there?
Yeah, yeah.
Almost out to there.
Oh, shit. That's going to be big.
Yeah, that's going to be a bit of a project, you know? It's keeping me occupied.
you'll have fields to build, things to build. Is this, like, a natural spawn village?
Yeah, this is a natural spawn one. All of these, except for one, is going to get removed. And
oh, I see.
The one that's going to stay is the one we're going to look at next.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
By the way, beautiful bridge.
Thank you.
I do like the bridge. Oh, I fell off.
Get up here before you spoil anything for yourself.
Okay.
We're going to look beneath the bridge after this, but...
Oh, okay. I didn't see anything. I was just flying too fast.
This is the house that I first took up residence in when I started my world. I basically spawned over there and went to look at a boat out this way.
Yeah.
I don't know, is your render distance far enough now that you can see the boat out there?
Yeah, I can see a boat out here.
Yeah, I went to that boat to get some resources. Swimming on the way back, I saw this village and I decided that this would be my house.
It is a cute village. Like, have you added anything?
Kind of. I mean, have you looked behind you?
Oh
yeah, I have added a detail or two.
No, I mean, I like. Did you add these?
No.
No, I don't think I've seen a house spawn like this. This is.
I didn't know if I was gonna have to be insulted or like.
Is these also naturally spawned?
Yeah, probably.
This felt more decorated, this house, than
yeah. Well, the inside is, as you can see here, like we got some stuff, remnants from episode one, and I think in this chest. In there you can see my very first tools. That wooden pickaxe is the first pickaxe I did on the server. And in here it's like my first iron and stone axes and stuff.
Oh, I see.
This is going in a museum someday. I'm debating what to do with this house.
I see. I found a door.
Yeah, I see that. I can see it. I think maybe I'll move this house, like... Mm-hmm. Take lots of screenshots and move it into like a museum somewhere.
Oh,
because it is a bit in the way of progress here.
Yeah. I get that.
But I want to keep it as it is. So
maybe you could build a museum around it, so you don't have to move your original like spawn.
Yeah, but that's gonna be a bit big. Is the thing.
Oh, I see. But it's gonna be in town anyway. So if this is in town, maybe.
Yeah. So if you come down here. This has been a bit remodeled. This is a little nice area you can hang out.
Okay, yeah. This is a really nice road. I do like the red decorated on this road, like the bushes on the side.
Yeah, and this is awesome. Look at this down here.
Oh, how cute.
This is what
it's almost like a little ice cream shop or something.
Yeah, exactly. It's a little pop-up shop this way. This way, good sir. This is probably my favorite area so far. One of them.
Oh.
There's a lot of custom trees.
This greenhouse is so stunning.
I know. It's so cool.
It's so stunning. It's so nice. Yeah. Like
the brick house.
This brick house is also very very pretty, but the green one. Oh my god! This is the contrast between the dark wood and the green also is very very pretty.
It does add a little something, doesn't it?
Yeah. It just pops. And I do like that it's tall. Yes, okay.
This is like one of the back alleys. This is going to give you a feel for how it's going to be walking through the city.
Oh, it's a new light design. Nice.
Yeah. Come this way.
There's just so many things to look at.
Yeah, I know.
Can I walk inside? Oh, let's not
Look inside. So this is a little bit of a sneaky peek of what I want the city to feel like once it's done, you know?
Yeah, this like it feels like... Oh, when I was in Italy, There was like small things when you walk through them, and like people hang their flowers and decorate their walls with things, and had like a lot of ivy growing on them, and like clothes hanging over their balconies and stuff like that.
And they hang the pigs up on the clotheslines to dry them.
Oh shit, there's a pig?
Yeah, I know. The animals in here are strange.
How did it get up there?
Well, if I knew, I would answer that.
what's his name?
He doesn't have a name. I'm trying to ignore him and hoping he goes away. Oh, that way I don't have to explain him.
Can I name him?
Well, then he's a permanent fixture. I guess you can.
Oh, that's cool. We're back here.
Yeah, we're back here. Look, this is bigger and better things out this way.
Oh, but there are no bigger and better things.
Yet.
I see. Basttown.
Yeah.
Backstreet. Oh, is this the backstreet?
Yeah, this is the backstreet, yeah. And this way is the city center.
Okay.
But there's not much of it yet. There's mostly like concrete pillars of doom.
I do like this house too.
You can go inside that one.
You can?
Ooh. Yeah.
Oh, no, is this a parkour?
Well, parkour. It's not intended to be one.
Parkour. Oh, I'm not good at it, apparently.
Well, no. Here you got a little balcony.
Pretty
nice, looking out over, nothing yet, but soon,
looking
maybe.
Looking out over the bigger things, better things.
Bigger, better things. Yeah, yes. Yeah. Oh, don't miss this one.
Where is down? I don't... Oh, thanks.
Yeah, good. And there's one here as well. Yeah, good.
Thanks.
I'm gonna have to go through all my world after this.
So.
Do you see this? Do you see how this works, by the way? This is a little cool building trick you can keep. And
do you have
use...
water underneath it, or
no.
Water inside the wall?
These blocks are stairs. Waterlogged stairs. In the wall.
Wait. This brick, is it brick stairs?
Yeah.
Ooh, that's clever.
That way you can hide a water source in the wall.
It takes no space.
It doesn't take any space, no. And you can grow stuff up here.
That's clever.
And if you look behind you, this is the newest building. I built this last episode.
That's also it's a cool window.
It is a cool window. It's gonna get more detailed as this project goes along. I really like this. It's a like fire escape kind of thing here. You can actually go up.
No.
Well, you should be able to. There you go.
I just thought I'm not able to.
Yeah, exactly. Anyone else can, but not you. The doors are fake, by the way. It's just tomfoolery.
Perfect. Well, that's really cool. I like the yellow house. That was actually really pretty.
Yeah, it's a bold choice, but like it's really cool.
No, but it fits the vibe. Like,
it
of course,
does.
There's like different people owning the houses and different people doing different things with them.
Exactly.
So I think it's like it fits that it's different things.
Yeah. This is spoiler alert. The thing I'm gonna tackle in this episode.
Oh, I see. Not to be like that, but this looks a little bit empty.
What? Really?
Yeah. At least I have cover from the rain here.
But what is a house but cover from the rain? Huh?
That's true. I might also need a bed, but that's...
Yeah, well, we can solve that easily.
Oh, perfect. Then I'm ready to move in.
No, well, I'm gonna flesh them out a little bit, of course. This is currently the concrete pillar of doom stage of the building.
Okay.
And
do you always make them in concrete?
Well, I did this time because I happen to have a lot of white concrete for.
Oh, I see.
Oh, have you seen this?
There's a fire up there.
Yeah. Get up there.
Oh, okay.
Welcome to the floating fortress of creeper destruction.
Oh.
I took my revenge upon the creepers. You can't see the remnants of it anymore because I covered the land, but I kind of went around and blew up creepers with TNT. Yeah, it was a fun episode.
Which episode was that?
Episode 6.
Maybe I should watch that.
And maybe you should watch that too. So my initial plan was to like lure the creepers and then just drop TNT from this hatch here.
Oh, I thought you were going to like surprise them, stand on it and like, woo!
Surprise! I think I would have been the one who got the surprise in that situation.
Might be. I took a lot of health.
Take a good look at this, because, well, not to spoil anything, but it's going away today. It's currently in the way of progress, and you know, as anything in the way of progress, it needs to go.
Oh, okay.
Let me show you one of the grindy little projects I've done on this world.
Yeah, whoop!
Oh, yeah, you were right on the way to it, right there.
Oh, I was?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's I meant that all along.
This was a ravine.
Oh.
Yeah.
Wait, so open to the surface?
Yeah, all the way. I built
you covered
a roof.
The ceiling.
Yeah, two layers. Oh. One for the inside and one for the top side.
That's cool.
Yeah, because there was going to be a city up there. And if you go here as well, this is going to be a cool little thing.
Mm-hmm.
This leads back to the original... Oh, why am I swimming so slowly?
Yeah, is there like swimming fatigue?
I don't know. You see, we're back here.
Oh, I can see now. That's going to be a church of some sort or something.
Spoilers. I have plans for it. Later today, you'll see. You'll see. After this, I'm going to start with it after this. Is your elytra doing well?
Yeah, it's full health, almost.
is your elytra doing well?
No.
Good! Then we can take a look at the end farm, where we can get some XP.
Oh!
Smooth.
That was very smooth.
Almost as smooth as this transition. I'm probably just gonna do some weird cut right here. If you look behind you now, that is my Enderman farm.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
This is like the prettiest farm I've seen.
Thank you. I try to make beautiful farms.
Oh, I never do. I build for function.
Wait, hold on. Oh lord, not again. Oh, come on. Hostile creatures down. There we go.
I'm shearing them.
Oh, don't, because there's wool beneath you.
Oh. Mine is fully healed now.
Yeah, mine too. I mean, it's not a super efficient. I mean, you could probably make this more efficient than this is.
No, this looks very efficient.
Far enough away from the, island.
Yeah.
And it is
even
pretty
more
efficient.
If it has at Y level 0, but this is efficient.
That's basically all I've built in the end. I just wanted to show you this farm, because you're a farm guy.
No, it was a very pretty farm. I do like the rainbow bow thing, and like the labyrinth pattern in the ceiling.
This is, by the way, the original campsite. I used to live here. This was my bed, where this stone pillar is.
Did you have it on top of it, or?
Oh yeah, the bed was right on top of here, yeah.
Huh.
Nice and covered from rain.
It has left a cover on the mark on the ground.
Oh, well, I marked it here because I want to know where it was, you know? This was the original.
That's cool.
I lived here for like 10 episodes. So, you know, this is my world. And, you know, welcome back when you want.
Oh, when I want.
Well, you know, I don't really know how you got here, but I mean...
Oh, that's true.
When you are able to get here, you can absolutely come visit. And maybe next time you come visit, we can do some fun project or go on an adventure or something.
Oh, that sounds wonderful.
Yeah.
I would like that.
Yeah. For now, I just wanted to show you around, this.
Yeah. I like it. What you've done here is amazing. I have seen all of your episodes. But
Of course. Yeah,
of course. All of them. Yes.
Yes. And, so you weren't surprised in the least to see any of this.
Yeah, no, not so surprised at all. But it's beautiful. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful
Thank
place.
You.
I like it a lot.
I've spent quite a few hours on it.
I can tell.
Getting close to 500 hours now.
It's very,
yeah,
very cool.
That's a lot for me for a single player world.
Yeah, 500 hours is a lot of hours.
That is a lot of hours.
Yes.
And this city has taken quite a few of them, and it's gonna take more.
Yeah, I can tell.
Yeah.
But also, I can also tell that it's gonna be wonderful.
And next time you come visit, there's gonna be more of it.
Oh, that's perfect. I would love to see more of that town. It's the cat is talking to us.
As long as you don't go into the houses. And you know, maybe there's some interiors next time you get here. Maybe.
Maybe. Who knows how
long time it takes. Yeah, just might be. So it's been fun having you over, going for a visit and stuff, you know.
Thanks for having me.
It
was great.
So how are you getting back exactly?
I goodbye.
That is so strange. Well, it's been fun with a visitor, but you know what? Let's move on with the project. We have quite a few things I want to get done in this episode. So, let's head down to the city.
You know, it is rather unusual to have visitors in a single-player world, but I quite enjoyed it, and I'm sure there is going to be more of it. Don't expect it every episode, though. It's going to be a thing, but it will happen when it happens, you know? I can't control when these guys pop into the world, and they're just gonna... it's just gonna happen. So, you know, keep watching the episodes, and there'll be more of them. For now, we should get working on the city. And I know you're probably as excited to see this as I am to build it. I've found some really cool color palettes that I am so excited to work with. So, I am going to build all of these three houses. Yeah, I know this is a grindy one. But first, I'm going to have to remove the floating fortress of creeper destruction. Although it is a fun part of our world and a memory to one of my favorite episodes to make, it just can't stay. I've tried to incorporate it into a building, but it just doesn't quite work with the plans I have. So unfortunately, it'll have to go. But with that said, I think there's only one way we can remove this structure. And as you might have guessed, the one respectful way to get rid of this building is some good old-fashioned TNT. So, let's give this building a proper farewell. This should take care of business. Thank you for your service, Tower. It's been a pleasure. Maybe we should use more TNT. You know what? This is starting to feel like the creeper explodificating episode all over again, actually. This feels rather familiar. Now, this should be enough, right? Let's try it. 3, 2, 1, go! Send it! That did it. Now, let's continue with what we were actually doing.
And you know what? Since this building already got a little bit damaged from all the TNTing, you know, why don't we start with that one? I think it's the smallest one as well, so it'll be a good warm-up. Yeah. Let me start a little quick time-lapse, and let's get building. People, two down and one to go. And what do you think of it so far? I really, really like these buildings. I love the way they came out. They're gonna look so nice. And as you maybe saw earlier, I had to change my plans slightly because, well, I thought Main Street got a little bit too tight. Kind of no matter the angle, you still don't get much of a clear view out there. You can still see it, which is fine. But it is obstructing the view very nicely, just the way I want it to. So I had to give this a little bit more space, just because this building here popped out a little further than I kind of wanted it to initially. With that said, I would like to get this video done, and I would like to get this grind done. So let's start this final building, which is going to be the most grindy building as well. Anyways, let the grind begin. Main Street, my dear Main Street, you are getting beautiful, and as a fine wine, you will only get better with time. This is really, really working for me. I love how these buildings came out. Mind you, there will be more details as we go along, but the ones I added so far, I really, really like. Like this bell in the clock tower, which I absolutely love. And the little antennae on this building, which I think might be a police building. It's definitely some sort of office, but I'm not sure yet what it would be. We'll see as time goes along. But as you can see, the skyline is improving. And if we go back here, I know we went here in episode 10 for a short little bit to see what the skyline looked like, and look at this. This is starting to look like a city. Imagine a few more rooftops there and maybe something back here, and you have a full city on your hands. And the view is not good just outside of the city, it's also very beautiful coming into it from our lovely, lovely Basstown. I absolutely love the clock tower poking up there. And this, like, office building as well, with the antennae and everything. So, so, so cool. And besides, another one of the things I really wanted with this city, the visibility through here will be limited, which is perfect. That means we can hide something really cool back there. I wonder what that could be. Maybe something big. Maybe something really, really, really big. In the future, of course. Not today, because, well, dear lovely, lovely viewers, this is all I have time for. As you can imagine, it's like Tuesday, and I usually release videos on Mondays, so I'm running a bit late on this one. Sorry about that, the grind was real for this, and you're gonna have to get used to it because, well, I am gonna start slipping on the schedule from now on, and that is gonna have to be fine. I do have a job, after all, that I need to do outside of YouTube until one day, maybe, hopefully, where we might be able to do this as a job. That would be cool. And the way to help me get there is by subscribing, liking the video, and maybe leaving a nice comment in the comment section down below. And until I see you next time,
I hope you have a good day, morning, night, or whatever it is, wherever you are. For now, bye.